I was never trying to build an organization. I was trying to build a movement. And I saw a nonprofit as just a structural way to basically go about doing that. And because I've been an organizer since I was, I led my first march when I was 13. You know, that allowed me to figure out how do you build a movement. And by building a movement, what I mean is like, I think to be a founder, you have to be able to tell a good story. You got to be able to stand up and like basically tell a story about what you're doing and what the world is going to look like. And you got to inspire other people to move along with you. And so with Girls Who Code, with everything, the colors we picked, you know, the t-shirts that we had, the logos that we had, the story was always about the girls and what would happen if girls learned how to code, that they would be healers, that they would be teachers, that they would be presidents, that they would be everything and anything. And once you told that story, people were like, sign me up. Where do I write the check? Where do I mentor? Where do I volunteer? And so my experience in law and politics and just quite frankly, public speaking helped me become a really good storyteller. And that's my superpower. And that's why even in the second movement that I've built, you know, Girls Who Code has about 18% global name recognition, which is insane after 10 years. Marshall Plan for Moms has 15% global name recognition after 9 months, right? Which is really hard to do, but I knew how to do it because I did it before. And so that I think is like really like, and I wouldn't have been able to know how to be a good storyteller, how to be a big movement builder, how to bring people along, how to inspire them into action, you know, had I not had a career in law and politics.